Welcome to the Vue Mention component tutorial. Using the Vue Mention component, you can tag or reference individuals, groups, or entities within a text input field, usually in a messaging or social media context. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Vue Mention component to a Vue app. I will demonstrate how to customize the height and width for the pop-up and the mention trigger character. I will also show you how to add a suffix to the mention, change the filter type, and sort items. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest versions of Vue and Node.js. To create a project in Vue, open Visual Studio Code and type the npm create vite@latest command. I provide the app name, my Vue app. Next, choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. After creating the Vue project, I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. To add the Syncfusion Vue Mention component, install the Syncfusion Vue dropdowns package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-dropdowns --save command. This command will install the package with its dependencies. The next thing I must do here is to register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. To start using the mention component, I open the app view file and remove the default code. I import the mention component from the Syncfusion Vue dropdowns package and register it globally with its child directives. Then I add the mention component by adding the EJ's mention tag. To add the CSS styles, I need to import the necessary CSS references. I can import the Vue mention component CSS in the style tag or refer to the CDN link in the index.html file. So let me open the index.html file and refer to the CDN link, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 components. I need to add this mention component to a target element. Here, I plan to add the rich text editor component as the target element and append the mention component. So let me install the RTE package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-rich-text-editor --save command. Then I import the component from the Syncfusion Vue Rich Text Editor package and register it globally with its child directives. To access the various features of the RTE, I need to import the necessary modules from the package and inject them into the Provide section. Then I add the component by adding EJ's rich text editor tag with the ID property to use this as the target element. To add the mention component to RTE, I set the target property to the ID value using a hash tag like this. Next, I must bind a data source to the mention component. So inside the data function, I declare an array variable userData and define the name and email ID fields with appropriate values. Then I bind this user data to the mention component using the data source property. I am going to display the name field in the mention suggestion list. So let me define an object, comments fields, and bind the name field to the text and assign this object to the fields property. Next, save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. You can see the rich text editor component rendered. When I type the special character at, the pop-up opens with the usernames in the suggestion list. By default, the height of the pop-up is 300 pixels and the width is auto. To customize the height and width, use the pop-up height and pop-up width properties. To demonstrate, I set the pop-up height to 200 pixels and pop-up width to 250 pixels. You can see the suggestion drop-down is displayed with the custom height and width. Once I select an item from the suggestion list, you will only see the selected item displayed in the target component. To display the mention character at, enable the Show Mention Care property. To do that, I set the Show Mention Care property to true. See, the character at is also displayed with the selected item. Usually the suggestion list is triggered when the default trigger character at is typed, but you can also use different characters to trigger. To demonstrate this, I will use the hash character to trigger the mention. I set the mention care property to hash. When I type hash in the rich text editor, see the suggestion list is displayed. Suppose I want to add a text, space, or a new line after an item is selected, use the suffix text property. Here, I am going to add the text welcome. So I set the suffix text property to welcome. Look at the component. When I select an item from the suggestion list, welcome is added as the suffix. When I type the first name Selma and add a space to type the second name, the suggestion list closes. To show the suggestion list after a space and retrieve items, I set the allow spaces property to true. Looking here, when I type the first name Selma and a space, the suggestion list is visible and retrieves items after the space. By default, items in the suggestion list are shown in the data source order, but you can also sort them in ascending or descending order using the sort order property. Let me demonstrate by setting this sort order property to ascending. Look, the items in the mention component are sorted in ascending order. By default, the contains filter type is applied to filter the names. Apart from this, the Syncfusion Mention component also supports two other filter types, starts with and ends with. Now, I want to filter the list with the ends with. So let me set the filter type property to ends with. Looking here, when I type some characters, the relevant suggestion items are shown in the pop-up. In this video, I have shown you how to add the mention component to a Vue application. You have seen how to integrate it into Vue RDE, customize the height and width of the pop-up, and customize the mention trigger character. I also showed you how to add a suffix, change the filter type, and sort items. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to obtain a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.